present in all places and filling all things, treasury of goodness and giver of life, come and abide in us, cleanse us from every stain of sin, and save our souls, O gracious Lord. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and forever and into the ages of ages. Amen. All Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, forgive our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for the glory of your name. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the age of ages.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Come, let us worship and bow down before Christ himself, our King and our God. Bless the Lord, O my soul. My God, you are very great. You are clothed in praise and honor, who covered yourself with light as with a garment, spreading out the heavens as a curtain. You cover your chambers with the waters. You make the clouds your chariot. You walk on the wings of the wind. You make the angel spirits and your ministers a flaming fire. You establish the earth on its sure foundation. It shall never be moved. You covered it with the deep as with a garment. The waters shall stand on the hills. At your rebuke they shall flee. At the voice of your thunder they shall be alarmed. They go up to the places and down to the plains, to the place which you founded for them. You have set a boundary which they shall not pass. Neither shall they turn again to cover the earth. You send forth fountains among the valleys. The waters run between the mountains. Shall give drink to all the beasts of the fields. The wild donkeys shall quench their thirst. By them the birds of the heavens shall have their habitation. They shall sing among the rocks. You water the mountains from your chambers. The earth is satisfied with the fruit of your miracles. You make grass grow for the cattle and vegetation for the service of man, that you may bring bread out of the earth and wine that gladdens the heart of man. Oil to make his face cheerful, and bread which strengthens man's heart. The trees of the plain shall be full of sap, even the cedars of Lebanon which you planted. Their birds will build their nests. The stork has her home in the fir trees. The high mountains are a refuge for stags, and the rocks for the rabbits. You appointed the moon for seasons. The sun knows his going down. You make beasts of the forest. You make darkness till it is night. And it all the wild beasts of the forest creep about. Young lions roar for prey and seek their food from God. The sun rises and they gather together and lie down in their dens. Man goes forth to his work and to his labor until the evening. O Lord, how great are all your works. In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is filled with your creation. Great and wide sea, in which are innumerable living things, both small and great. There sail the ships, and there is Leviathan, which you have made to play. All wait for you to give them their food in due season. When you give it to them, they will gather it up. When you open your hand, they shall be filled with goodness. But when you turn away your face, they shall be troubled. When you take away their breath, they fail. To their dust. You send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works, who looks upon the earth and makes it tremble, who touches the mountains and they smoke. I will sing praises to my God as long as I live. May my meditation be sweet to him. I will rejoice in the Lord. and sinners and wicked men disappear from the earth, and may they be no more. Bless the Lord, O my soul. The sun knows its going now. You make darkness and it is night. O Lord, how great are your works. In wisdom you have made them all. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Lord, you are our hope. Glory to you.
Give me the strength of the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Give me peace and the salvation of our souls. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For peace in the whole world, as the peace of God's holy churches, and for the ones of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Thank you. Lord, hear my voice. Sufletele noastre. Thank you. Amen.
Grant, Lord, that we may
night without sin. Blessed are you, Lord, God of our fathers, and praised and glorified your name forever. Amen. May your mercy be upon us, Lord, just as we have hope in you. Blessed are you, Lord, teaching your judgment. Blessed are you, Master, give me understanding of your judgment. Blessed are you, Holy One, enlighten me with your judgment. Lord, your mercy endure forever. Do not disregard the works of your hand. To you is due praise, to you is due song, glory is due to you. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us complete our prayer, the
Lord. Mercy.
Help us, save us, and mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, mercy.
God is holy and he made perfect. Holy, peaceful, and sinless, and the sons of the Lord.
Grounded is, O Lord.
Angel of peace, a faithful guide, the guardian of our souls and bodies, with the sons of the Lord.
Grounded is, O Lord.
Pardon and forgive us of our sins and thanks us, with the sons of the Lord.
Grounded is, O Lord.
For our souls and for peace in the whole world, let us ask of the
Lord.
That we may live on the rest of our days in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord.
Lord.
A Christian ending to our life, painless, shameless, and peaceful. In a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant
us, O Lord. Remembering our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and a glorious lady, that the Apostles and ever Virgin Mary.
Most holy, Theotokos, save.
Ne stricăciune și viață dă-i neamul. has settled on earth, it shall remain unmoved. O Christ, the transgressor of the law, delivered you to Pilate and condemned you to be crucified, proving how ungrateful they were to their benefactor. By your own free will, you suffered being buried in the tomb. You rose on the third day, but you were, by your own power, bestowing upon us eternal life and great mercy. Slumber, God,
give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the
evil.
Thank you.
Gregory Paramas was Archbishop of Thessaloniki during the 14th century, and he was a teacher of the uncreated energy which spring forth from God and can be perceived by the spiritual people, by the faithful people who are looking for the divine. So if you consider the first and the second Sunday, you can understand that this first half of Great Lent has dogmatic connotations, because if we are talking about the third Sunday, this is dedicated by the Holy Fathers to the veneration of the Holy Cross. At the mid-Lent, we receive strength for the Holy Cross from the veneration of the Holy Cross, which is the most important thing in our lives as Christians. And then we pass to the fourth Sunday, which is this Sunday tomorrow, which is dedicated to the commemoration of Saint John of the Latter, the author of a famous spiritual writing, the Letter of the Divine Ascent. If we are taking into consideration then the coming Sunday, the fifth Sunday of Great Lent, is dedicated to Saint Mary of Egypt, we understand that this second part of Great Lent is kind of dedicated to ascetical struggles and efforts towards fasting. Speaking about John the Latter, he lived during the end of 6th century, beginning of 7th century, he died in 649. And the request of Abbot John, who was the leader of a neighbor of a nearby monastery of Raid, he has written this spiritual treatise on the spiritual struggles of the monks towards heaven. The treatise has 30 chapters in our life, and this is meant mainly for the monks, but of course, since this is the first recommendation of spiritual readings during Great Lent, could be of use for all of us as we struggle, as we feast, as we put all our spiritual powers and at work during this period, exceptional period of time of Great Lent. And I will just read
Orthodox and non-Orthodox.
These words on obedience should be of importance, since we are Christians. And only last Sunday, it was a Sunday dedicated to the Holy Cross, we could hear the words of our Lord: whoever wishes to come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross and follow me. So obedience and following Christ, this is something you should reflect upon in the coming days, and this should be something important on our path towards the resurrection. I think we end here this wonderful day, and I would like to thank again our host, the Dean, and all the staff, and all of you for participating, the speakers, and all of those who are in attendance this whole day. May God bless all of you and offer you the strength to continue the spiritual journey through Lent, so you can enjoy the great statement at the end of this great Lent, that Christ is risen. Thank you again, and may God bless all of you. Amen.
Lands for guest speakers and members of the choir. We meet in the combination of to make me the life easier. The guest speaker, the dean, member of the choir.